What's up everybody, I'm Gushy. In today's video, we're going to be going over all the legendaries in the game so far and tiering them. We'll look at the perks that they provide, how they can be used, and how they could synergize with other weapons. As a disclaimer, please let me know in the comment section down below if you agree with me or disagree with me, because I want to hear your guys' opinion, and you might have some kind of way to use these legendaries in a way I haven't thought of. So with that, let's get started. So first up, we have Masamune's Edge. With this, melee attacks have a 20% chance to deal double damage. This comes with a default stance of wind. And this one's just alright. In the single player story, we had a way to buff these percent chances with the Charm of Fortune, but in Legends, there's nothing like that. So a 20% chance is pretty low. And as you can see in this example, out of all the times I hit this guy, I haven't got that double damage to proc. So because of that low 20%, I put it in D tier. Next up is the Demon Cutter. Staggering a target has a 30% chance to throw nearby enemies. The stance that it comes with is Moon. And as you can see in this example, it doesn't happen all the time with that 30%, but when the perk procs, the AoE is pretty big and knocks targets pretty far back. So this could be really useful for things like survival, especially if you have that perk Impactful Throws, which will knock down enemies for a couple seconds when they're thrown back. So it has some pretty good synergy, but again, since the percent chance is only 30%, I'll put it in C tier. Alright, next up is the Master's Katana. With this katana, you can switch between any stance. And for sure, this is S tier. With the ability to switch between each stance and stagger enemies easier, you'll be doing more DPS and killing enemies faster. Next up, we have Yoshitsune's Hand. The default stance is Water, and staggering a target has a 30% chance for the target to be knocked down. It's pretty similar to the Demon Cutter, but only affects one target. And in this example, after all this time using it against these enemies, I couldn't get it to proc. But if it does, it's a free crit. Again, because of that low percent chance, I'll put it in C tier. Next is the Stonebreaker. This will grant the player, regardless of class, the ability to use Heavenly Strike. It also has an additional perk that says that if you use Heavenly Strike against a staggered enemy, it'll do extra damage and repel nearby enemies. But for this perk, the main reason why you'd want to use this is for that extra damage against staggered enemies. So as you can see in this example, since this guy still has his guard up, we have that normal animation for Heavenly Strike and kills these guys with 3 health bars. However, if I take down their guard first, then this Heavenly Strike move does this 2 slash move and does around 5 bars of damage. So if you're going for a stagger build with a really quick damage burst using Heavenly Strike to get around twice as much damage, I say it's pretty good, so I'll put it at A tier. Alright, onto the ranged weapons. Alright, next up is Heaven's Sting. These darts have a 20% chance to instantly kill non-Oni targets. Insta-killing anything is always good. With that risk-reward factor, if you're using this to take down large enemies like captains or really annoying brutes, this could be really useful. But again, it only has a 20% chance. So even though it has a percent chance, the effect is really good. So I'll put it in B tier. Next up, we have the Weightless Spirit. This short bow makes it so that arrows don't descend. And with this, you don't have to worry about arrow drops. You could be sniping people across the map. Even if you don't pull the bow all the way back, it'll do less damage, but still fly in a straight line. So it's a cool concept, and I'd say it's pretty good. But since we have our next legendary weapon, I'll rate this a little lower at C tier. So this next legendary weapon is the Skipping Stone Bow. And if you don't know about this already, this is a must for all hunters. With this, headshots ricochet to nearby enemies. And this is perfect for things like survival where enemies are always clumped together, and because it works with your ultimate, where you can get 10 headshots all together with all your techniques and abilities. We have the Forbidden Medicine Bombs, and its effect has bombs healing allies caught in the blast. This isn't noted in the description, but it will also heal yourself as well. And this is a really good secondary perk that'll give you extra healing, but honestly doesn't heal that much. So this won't be your main source of healing, as you'd have to spam it a bunch of times just to get to full health. So you'd have to use it with other things like the healing gourd or the perk combat regeneration. But it is a good backup for healing. So with that, I'll put it at A tier. Moving on to our charms. First charm we have is Sacred Iron. Enemies that deal melee damage to you have a weaken applied to them. Personally, I really think that weaken's a really strong status effect within the game, as it has enemies doing 25% less damage and taking 25% more damage. So, weaken is an offensive and defensive tool. I'd say in the higher difficulties where you don't want to get hit that much, this doesn't apply that much as it only affects the targets that you get hit by, and because it targets a single person, I'd put it around B tier. Next up we have Angel's Remorse. Deal 15% bonus damage when at full health. Comparing this to all the properties that you can roll with on each piece of gear, 15 is actually a pretty high number. Some properties don't even go above 10%, so that alone is a plus. It does have the restriction of you being at full health, but I'd say with certain classes like the Hunter and the Assassin, where you're always out of range or invisible, trying to go for crits or assassinations, or if you're another class and you're just really good at not getting hit, or you have a tank build that focuses on health regeneration, that 15% bonus is massive. And because of that, I put it at S tier. Next up is Benkei's Last Stand, which will give you a 15% chance to ignore arrow damage. And as you might guess it, with a really low percent chance, and the fact that you don't take arrow damage that often, and are telegraphed by enemies saying "Dosho!", I'd put it at D tier. Next up is Last Breath. Instead of taking fatal damage, it'll heal you for 50 health, but it can only occur every 5 minutes. If you watch my nightmare guide, this is highly recommended, so you don't have to start over all the way from the beginning when you die. There is that restriction that it happens every 5 minutes, but if you're playing Nightmare to not die, you can easily just wait that 5 minutes if you want to play it really safe. And this basically gives you a second life. So because of that, I'll put it in S tier as well. Alright, next up we have the Shogun's Fortitude. This grants immunity to flash and poison effects. I don't think flashes are the problem, but poison. Poison is the worst because it whittles down your health, and with limited resources to healing, I'd say ghosts are pretty weak to poison. Also, if you get poisoned too long, you have that coughing animation, which leaves you wide open to attacks. So I'd say it's useful in some situations if enemies are using poison, but other than that, it's just alright, so I put it in B tier. Next up, we have Lady Sandro's Surprise. This dirt throw has a 15% chance to cause enemies to hallucinate, and hallucination is actually a pretty strong ability. It thins out the mob so that enemies fight each other, but again, with that 15% chance, I'd say it's a good side effect when it does happen, but you can't count on it all the time. And because of that, I'll put it at C tier. Next up, we have the Touch of Heaven. Similar to the Forbidden Medicine, this sticky bomb heals allies on hits. However, it has a major downside. Since sticky bombs auto aim, in this example, I'm trying to heal my ally by aiming it to the ground, but once I throw it, it auto locks to the nearest enemy. So this is only useful if you're in the fight close to the blast radius. And because of this, I'm gonna put it at C tier. Next up, we have the Spirit Kunai. Getting a kill with the kunai lowers all cooldowns on your character by 15 seconds. So this includes your weapons, your abilities, and so far this is the only thing that reduces cooldowns. If you're going for an ability build, this is the one to use. There's only one downside, in that you have to get a kill with the kunai. Outright, kunais don't do that much damage, so the perk Supermassive is a must for this weapon, as it'll give you extra damage and cause lighter enemies to get thrown back. And I'd say this is mostly useful on the Ronin because only Ronins have that technique to boost all ghost damage by 50%. It is class specific, but if you are running a Ronin, I'd say it is A tier. Alright, next up is the Mist of Yagata. This smoke bomb heals allies in the smoke. And at first I thought this was pretty bad. One, because the heals aren't that much and smokes are on a 120 second cooldown. But after playing around with it sometime, because smokes are so good, it has a lingering effect of around 8 to 10 seconds where you can get free critical hits or res allies. With that extra benefit of smokes healing you, it provides a really good crowd control option for you to use. Especially in survival, we have to control a certain point. So I initially put it at S tier, but I think because the healing is so little, this really doesn't offer you much more than a regular smoke bomb. So because of that, I'll drop it down to A tier. Next up, we have Kenji's Shared Brew. This healing gourd also heals nearby allies. I always recommend Strong Brew on every healing gourd, so you could be healing allies more. So that's a must for sure. But there is one downside. If you are trying to heal an ally, but you're already at full health, you can't use the gourd. So that's a really good support weapon. But because of its restrictions, I'll drop it down to B tier. So finally, our last legendary is Demon Seeds. These caltrops apply weaken effects to affected enemies. And so again, I really like the weaken status effect, and in combination with the perks that it has, Fired Up or Deep Bags are a really good option to control a space or get more damage in. And I know that caltrops isn't a really popular ghost weapon, but personally, I really think it's an underrated one. But with that, I'll put it around B tier. And so yep, this is our final list, with our S tiers being the Master Katana, the Skipping Stone Bow, and Joe's Remorse Charm, and the Last Breath Charm. I'm also hoping that the raid that comes out next week drops a raid-specific legendary, so when that does, I'll place that on this list as well. I wanted to also mention as well that if you don't have a group for the raid yet, I created a Discord, which I'll link down below in the description section. We have almost 100 people in this group already, and we have an LFG for all activities, survival, raid, story, or if you just want a place to talk about Ghost of Tsushima, whether that be builds or different skins you're going after, come join the community. With that, that's all the legendaries in the game with some gameplay and a tier list. Again, drop your comments down below if you agree or disagree with me. I always like hearing your guys' opinion and always learn something too. So, thank you guys for watching. Hope to catch you next one, and GG.